insights and tell us all about it. The next session is shedding light on the journey of IoT so far and the direction in which it's headed in the future. Please join me in welcoming up to the stage our first keynote speaker of the event, Mr. Nirushan Matampidigay. He's the head of delivery and agile coach at GapStars. He's going to be sharing his thoughts on the topic IoT now and the future.
Thank you. Good morning. That's not enough. Let's do this. It's going to be a fantastic long day. So I want you to start your day with a lot of energy. And I kindly request all of you to stand up for just a few seconds. And I'm just going to ask you to do just one little activity, simply because being techie guys, tech leaders, business leaders, it doesn't mean we need to find out the ways to be energized in whatever we do. So I'm going to ask you to shout out good morning, and this is going to be the loudest good morning that you have ever said in your life. And this is how it's going to work. I'm going to count up to three, and you're going to shout saying good morning. That's it. Are we ready?
Yes.
Here we go. One, two, three.
Good morning.
Thank you. Where do I start? Internet and Internet of Things. Something that changed the world is internet. That's the single word that has impacted every one of our lives by today. And there are three magical words in the tech world now. Internet of Things. What is it? Any guess? The term sounds very simple, but sometimes we misinterpret it and don't get the right meaning of it. Internet was a thing for people, created by people, for benefiting people. Now, all of a sudden, this new term, three words came up. That is Internet of Things. What does it do? Now, you have things, the physical things that are not live. And what you do there is you allow the things to share their experience with other things. When internet was invented, the intention was to benefit people and help the people communicate with each other. But now what's happening? Now we want the things to communicate with each other. How do you do that? It's very simple. So you have the things that includes every object that you see around you, including this, including my shirt, including anything that I wear, my watch, your chair, anything for that matter. So how you allow these things to communicate with other things is simply adding the ability to sense and communicate. So we know it. So with that, we want them to share the experiences with the other things. Isn't it? It's not something totally new. The history goes back to 1832, when magnetic telegraph was invented by someone. And I want to have a quick look at the history of Internet of Things, starting from the moment the World Wide Web was invented. So if you look back at the history, 1989, Tim Berners-Lee proposed the World Wide Web. 1990, John Romke created a toaster that could be switched on and off. 1991, the first web page was created by Tim Berners-Lee, and we all agree that that would have been the best invention. Otherwise, we will never talk about something like Internet of Things. Mark Weasel, a Scientific American article on ubiquitous computing called The Computer for the 21st Century, 93 Trojan Room coffee pot was located in the Trojan Room within the computer lab of the University of Cambridge, allow people to see the power of internet and remote ways of controlling physical objects. 1994, Steve Mann creates WearCam, which is the second cam introduced to the world of internet. 1995, the internet goes commercial with Amazon and eBay. That would have been a bigger step. And then 1997, Paul Saffer presents 1998, Google is incorporated, which is a big step. Without this, we would have come so far up to this point. In the same year, InTouch, a project at MIT was developed by Scott Brave, Andrew Dashley, and Professor Hiroshi Ishii. And 1998, Mark Weiser continues his exploration into topic and constructed a water fountain outside his office whose flow and height mimic the volume and price trends of the stock market. So it continues. 1999, a big year for the IoT and MIT. This is where we all started talking about this magical term, Internet of Things. The Internet of Things term is coined by Kevin Ashton, executive director of the Otto ID Center. In the same year, speaking about similar things from MIT Media Lab in his book, When Things Start to Think, was a big step as well. Otto ID Labs opens, which is the research-oriented successor to the MIT Otto ID Center, originally founded by Kevin Ashton, David Brooke, and Sanjay Sharma. Also, Neil Gross writes some interesting predictions in Business Week. So these are some of the things that allowed us to come so far. In 2000, starting off what is now becoming a meme, LG announces its first internet refrigerator plans. 2002, now this is another step, a big step as well. The ambient orb created by David Ross and others in a spin-off from MIT Media Lab is released into wild. And this product is still available in the market. So if you want to buy it, it's a rabbit which can operate on its own. Term IoT is mentioned in the mainstream publications like Guardian, Scientific America, and Boston Globe, which are some big steps as well. 2006 to 2008, recognition by the EU and the first European ITU conference is held. 2008, the FCC voted 5-0 approve operating the use of wide space spectrum. So these are big inventions that allowed us to evolve on the IoT subject. A group of companies launched the IPSO Alliance to promote use of internet protocol in networks of smart objects and enable the Internet of Things. And 2011 is the biggest year for IoT. I'll tell you why. The main reason is IPv6 public launch. The new protocol allows for 128 power of 2 addresses, or as Stephen Leibson put it, we could assign an IPv6 addresses to every atom on the surface of the Earth, and you can still do 100 plus more Earth. That is that big, and that is the scope that we have now. In 2011, there's another thing that happened. Gartner identifies that IoT is in the hype cycle of emerging technologies. And you can see that it has reached the top, but it's been identified in the trending technology stack. And in 2014, the same organization, Gartner, observes that IoT reaches the peak of inflated growth, according to their hype life cycle. And after 2014, it's somewhat declining, but you know, there is a bigger opportunity for us to invest and make use of this magical technology for betterment of our lives. Now, why I want to talk about the history about IoT is simply to let you know the subject and also let you realize that this is not something new. This is not something that has just happened. The roots of IoT goes back to 1832, if you look back at the history. What allowed us to evolve is the continuous technology improvement, continuous innovation. As people who want to improve our lifestyles, who